So hello, what's up guys, welcome back to another tutorial video. I hope you all are doing well. In today's video I'm going to show you how you can make a very simple bucket of tropical fish farm. You can also modify this farm into a normal fish farm later on, fish and bone meal farm, but first I'm going to show you how you can make a bucket of tropical fish farm. So further ado, let's hop into the tutorial. So the items you will need is 8 stack and 5 salt blocks. You can use any salt blocks. 2 water buckets, 8 slabs, 2 chests, 3 torches, 1 stack and 5 ladders, 1 stack and 14 carpets. You can use any type of carpet. You can also use leaves, slabs, glass block, cause we just need them to despawn the area, spawn proof the area, and 6 hoppers. To build this farm, first you need to find a warm ocean or lukewarm ocean. You can see a warm ocean or lukewarm ocean wherever you see this coral reefs. First you need to find them, cause tropical fish only spawns in warm ocean and lukewarm ocean. After finding where you want to make your farm, place the dirt and take it to the surface of the water. After placing the dirt whichever side you want to make the front of your farm, just place 2 salt blocks over here like this way. Now place a torch over here and then place a dirt salt block on top of the dirt block. And make a pillar of salt blocks until you reach Y level 128. After reaching Y level 128, turn to your right and then place a salt block. And then turn to your left and place 2 salt blocks. And then go down. Make sure you don't hit the blocks you place down. Now place 2 ladders over here and then crouch down and then keep placing and going up until you reach your top of the farm. After placing all the ladders, go to any one of the corner and then place 5 blocks in front of you. And now fill in this area with salt blocks. Now check which side you have previously placed the 2 salt blocks by turning to your left and then place 2 chests on that 2 blocks. And now come over here, crouch down and place a hopper going into the chest and then a hopper going into that hopper. Now place 2 hoppers going into that hopper and then 2 hopper going into these 2 hoppers. Now come over here and then place 2 salt blocks and then 3 salt blocks over here and then 3 over here and 2 over here. Now come over here, crouch down and then place 4 salt blocks and 3 over here and then 3 over here. Now place 2 slabs over here. Now place 4 salt blocks over here, 3 over here and then 3 over here and then 2 over here. Now come over this block and then extend 7 blocks in front of you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now do the same thing for the other side also. And now place 7 blocks in front of you. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now place 17 blocks in this side. In 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. After placing these 17 blocks, now fill in this whole area with salt blocks. After placing all the salt blocks, it should look something like this. Now come over here, place 2 salt blocks over here, then 3 over here and 1 over here. Now crouch down, come over here and make a 1 block high wall all around this platform like this way. Now keep this in mind that guys, you are not going to place salt blocks on top of these blocks, okay? You are going to continue it from here. It should be floating in the air, okay guys? After making the 1 block high platform, it should look something like this. Now take here whichever thing you are using to spawn proof this area and place all over this 1 block high wall. I'm using moss carpet because it looks very good also, and it is very cheap to get. If you don't know how to get moss carpet, or if you don't have any farm to get moss carpet, then I'll give a link to you in the description that how you can make a moss and azalea farm. After placing all the carpets, come over here and then place a water bucket in this block, and then come over here and then place a water bucket in this block. This will turn this into a infinite water source. Now fill in your water buckets and then do the same thing. Now again fill in your water buckets, come over here, then place a water bucket over on this block, then skip one block and then place a water bucket. Now collect water from the middle block and then skip one block and place a water bucket, and keep on doing this process until you reach to the other side. After placing all the water buckets, this row should look something like this. Now fill in your water bucket and place on this second block. As soon as you will place, this first block is going to turn into a water source block, as you can see. And again do the same thing, skip one block and keep placing water buckets. As you can see guys, fishes has already started spawning over here. Now just again fill in your water bucket and place one last water bucket over here. So what happens is that fishes always try to swim to the deepest side of the ocean. So now come over here and then place four ladders so that you can access the top, and then place one torch over here and one over here. Now place three slabs over here and then three slabs over here so that phantoms don't spawn upon you at night. Now just collect two water buckets and then catch two fish like this way. Now if you want, you can also use this farm as an XP farm, because if you kill fishes they will give you XP. So this is a pretty good XP farm, and if your sword is having a looting 3 effect, then you are going to get a lot more loot. Now after killing the fishes, just go up and check that sometimes there might be chances of the after killing the fishes, the items might be at the top instead of collecting by the hoppers. So just always recheck. So now I'm going to show you once more how you can collect fishes. First fill in your water buckets and then catch the fishes this way. Now I'm going to show you how you can modify this farm into a fish farm. So to modify this, you will need these items: 3 hoppers, 6 normal lids, 2 powered lids, 2 chests, 4 magma cubes, 1 lever and 1 minecart with hopper. First come at the top and then place 2 sword blocks over here, and then 3 dirt blocks over here and 1 over here. Now kill any fish if it is inside. After killing the fishes, fill in this area with dirt blocks to drain the water, and now break these 4 dirt blocks. After breaking the dirt blocks inside, now break these 4 hoppers. Now break these 2 slabs and then break these 2 blocks. Now break these 2 hoppers. And then break this chest. Now break these 2 blocks. Place 2 chests over here. And now break this block. And then these 2 blocks over here. And then crouch down and place a hopper going into that chest. And then place 2 hoppers going into that hopper. Now crouch down and place 2 powder here, and then 3 normal rails over here, and then place 3 normal rails over here this way. Now place 2 saw blocks over here. Now come over here, then crouch down and then place a lever over on this block and then flick it. If you have made everything correctly, then this powder should get on. Now just place a minecart and then push it. Now place 4 magma blocks over here and then 2 sword blocks over here. Now just go up Then fill in your buckets with water. Then just turn this area into a water source block. And now you can break this dirt blocks. Now one thing keep in your mind, guys, that you should never fail in this bubble trap, because if you fall, then it will be a very hard time for you to come out. So these fishes will just come in this deep end and then die due to the magma blocks. As you can see, the drops are going to come over here. If you are using a looting 3 sword in the previous design where I showed you how to catch the tropical fish, then you would get more drops per hour, but this is also fine. You can use this way also. So that is it for today, guys. I hope you liked this tutorial. Make sure to like, share, subscribe, comment, turn the bell notification on, say me what should I make in my next video. Till then, it has been Nock here. Thanks for watching.